Hello, I'm Ann McKinney, and this is a short video lecture on the subject of using video lectures for your online course. It only seems appropriate to use this medium as a way of providing some context for video lecturing. And what I would like to discuss very briefly is some of the pros and cons associated with video lecturing so that you can make a more informed decision about whether this is something that you should be using in your own course as you as a course delivery method. Some of the advantages of using them, obviously, you get to see me and hear me, and it might bridge some of the gaps that exist in online courses between the students and the instructor. So, you know, you get a bit more than you would if you just saw my little tiny photo in Moodle and whatever I write in my text boxes. I could give hands-on demonstrations if I wanted to, say, teach a course that needed some hands-on demonstration. This would be a very apt way to go about that. And depending on how you teach and your lecturing style, if you're very comfortable lecturing in front of a classroom, this might be a very convenient venue for you to kind of recreate some of the atmosphere of the online classroom. And maybe make your course a bit more fun and engaging for the students if they have something to watch. And of course, that's going to be up to your judgment, just exactly how fun and quirky this is. Obviously, you get a bit more than just words, and you get some vocal cues and body language, and you get to see all of my interesting hand gestures. But on the con side, some negative issues associated with video files is that you're creating huge files for downloads. And depending on how you provide them to your students, if students are using dial-up, they may not be able to download the files at all. And especially if you have very long lectures, so you would want to really watch what you're saying as best as you can. Also, it can be very dry, especially if you're just reading from a script. You know, if you've seen a lot of service announcements out there that can be very dry and dull, and someone is just reading, blah, 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 you know, that's not really going to engage your students' attention for very long. But on the other hand, there are very good reasons for reading from a script, because if you don't, then you could be creating accessibility issues for the students with visual or audio impairments who would be missing out on part of the video lecture otherwise, and also for the students who may not be able to download the file because of their internet accessibility issues. So, providing a verbatim text copy in plain text that anyone could read on their own or with JAWS software is going to make the lecture much more accessible to all of your students, albeit a bit drier than if you were to, say, just do things off the cuff, as I'm doing today. And what I'm going to do after this lecture is over, once I post it to our course, is that I'm going to post it with a text summary of my arguments so that you can read the notes, but not necessarily read the entire script verbatim. And also, of course, if you create a video lecture, if your students are downloading it and are listening to it or watching it, are they really paying attention? Or do they just have the window open while they go off to Amazon.com and do a little shopping or whatever? You know, and there may not be a whole lot that you can do about that. But I can give you some suggestions for using video lectures in your class. For one thing, keep it short, keep it sweet, try to keep it to the point as best as you can. Also, provide some text file, whether it's verbatim or at least an outline of what you've covered. PowerPoint is also another way to go about this. But you know, also as long as you provide some software that all students can open and access. I like to use plain text or one of the course web pages on the site that students can all read. Media Lab. If you go to an actual Media Lab at your school, you are more likely to be able to create a much more polished, professional, very cool looking video. It may take a lot more time, but if it's something that you could reuse over and over every time you teach this course, then it would be a good investment for you. And on the other hand, as I mentioned, if you have a small, inexpensive digital video recorder, then you could create a whole series of quick, one-time-only video vodcasts that, you know, you can produce in a matter of minutes, you know, upload on your laptop, and then shoot it out to all of your students. It's up to you how you want to go about it, but hopefully this lecture has given you a bit more insight into the subject so that you can make an informed decision and decide if this is something that you are interested in pursuing with your own courses.